am Neelu Kedia.
My name is Poonam.
My name is Zinia Virani.
My name is Tanvi.
My name is Aparna Shah.
Until very recently, I've started allowing sugar as such. But until I used to use jaggery powder. I used to substitute sugar with jaggery initially, or sometimes with coconut sugar or something. I'm basically trying to avoid refined sugar as much as possible. But then, like, you know, once they're 2+, they have birthday parties, they start going to school, then it's very tough to control sugar.
Started sugar when she was 1, on her first birthday, when she actually had her cake for the first time. And my daughter is a big sweet tooth, so she absolutely loves eating candy, sweets, chocolates. So to a point where it actually affects her sometimes health-wise, and it gives her a big sugar rush. So hence I try to tame it down to a maximum of 1 chocolate, and that's preferably before dinner time.
So my sugar substitute is, because she is Bengali, we have something called Noren Gur, which is jaggery, which is made out of dates. So I try and put that if it is required. If, say, for example, I need to put any form of sweet in her food, so it could be a porridge, for example. So instead of putting sugar, I end up putting that. It's called Noren Gur.
I started letting them eat cake once they started understanding, maybe around 1.5 years, at birthday parties only, or if there's a family occasion. At home, I usually try to limit the sugar. I don't give them sugar at all. Like, if honey is okay or good, jaggery is fine, but just avoid, like, use sugar substitutes and don't give sugar. Like, I don't bring it into the house. That's the best.
So honestly, I have spoiled my son for that, and I'm suffering because he has teeth, like cavity in his teeth and all that. But he almost eats a chocolate every day. That's not good, but you know, when he comes with those eyes in front of me, I just can't say no to him.
Moms know best.
Moms know best.
Moms know best.